Now, the chances of a small wooden building surviving in the city, it has to be quite extraordinary in its architecture to get a lot of people interested. Everybody liked this building, the Ladd Carriage House. William S. Ladd was a founding citizen of the city. He made an enormous fortune, was a huge patron of the city, of the arts. He also was a man who loved horses. He had a wonderful mansion, and he needed a good stable for those horses, a carriage house.
And unfortunately, William Ladd was not able to enjoy his building for very long. He died not too soon thereafter. It stayed in the family until the family was pretty much no longer living in the downtown area, and it was sold off in 1926 to the Wanna Land Company. They converted it from a carriage house to mainly kind of a commercial shop sort of structure. And they sold it in 1970 to the First Christian Church. The church again did a major remodel in the early 70s, basically to support a law office. The church decided to basically redevelop their block, and they had owned the entire block, which is one of their principal assets, and they decided to put a tower in the north half of the block. And then there was the portion of the block where the carriage house sat, and it was questionable of whether the carriage house could or should remain on that block.
Well, the Friends had its genesis actually right at the very time that the church filed for a demolition permit. It was the church's way of getting the community aware of the fact that something had to be done, that the block was going to be redeveloped, and that one way or the other, something was going to happen with the carriage house. And the reaction that everybody had was, of course, they were horrified. And the church said, all right, then find some place to put it. Where do you put a 360-ton building? And the solution to that came from the Sixth Church of Christ Scientists. They owned the parking lot, and they agreed to do a deal with Opus Northwest to allow the carriage house to sit here for the 18 months while the foundation was being prepared over there at Broadway and Columbia. That all happened in a very sort of death-defying sequence of events. Every point along the way, we're sure we're going to lose the carriage house, and then something would come along that, yes, we could, we'll figure out a way. And it's been a bit of a miracle, quite frankly.
The unusualness of this great redevelopment has put the spotlight on preservation in a way that we usually don't see on our projects. Not only because of the relocation, which is unusual, but also because of the citizenry which stepped in to speak in support of the project and help encourage that it happen, I think has made this, the Ladd Carriage House, a bit of a poster child for historic preservation in Portland. The Opus people really would like this project finished in concert with the completion of the Ladd Tower. So that has meant we've needed to remove dry rotted structural members and siding. It means that we've had to scrape paint. We've tried paint samples on the building to help come up with the color scheme that we wish. We've removed windows that are going to be restored, the original windows, and started that restoration process. The roof is now complete, so we've actually got a pretty good head start on the construction schedule.
It's coming back soon. It's coming back this Saturday.